Hi everyone, I am Anton and I work with Froomel, the personalization engine for news companies. Now, Earl Wilkinson of the International News Media Association, or INMA, has recently made the observation that when it comes to personalization for news, perhaps personalization itself hasn't really lived up to the expectations. And I wanted to take the chance to weigh in on that. Now, one of the biggest reasons why I believe perhaps personalization hasn't really lived up to its expectations is because I think those expectations that we have of it are based on our experiences with platforms such as Spotify, Netflix, and Instagram. And what these platforms do is they really put personalization front and center of their entire platform. They have made personalization a key competitive advantage of their organization. Now, here's a difference that immediately stands out. The tech giants have put personalization behind just about every impression of a customer, just about every spot on their webpage or on their app is driven by intelligence. While publishers, on the other hand, still have these very carefully, very doubtfully placed popular articles widgets or similar articles widgets all the way at the bottom of a homepage or all the way at the end of an article page. Now, you simply cannot expect to get the same results from personalization as the tech giants do when they put personalization front and center of their experience. Now, this immediately brings me to a solution, or to at least a part of the solution of how to get closer to the same level of impact. And that is, as a publisher, you cannot populate your entire real estate of your website or your app with popular articles widgets or similar articles widgets. But what you can do is you can put intelligence behind every one of your sections. You can put intelligence behind a regional news section to allow it to detect the regions in which your reader is interested in reading about. You can put intelligence behind a sports widget to allow it to detect the sports teams and sports categories your reader is interested in reading about and offering personalized content recommendations accordingly. And you can do the same for business news, for foreign news, for cultural news, for political news, and for whatever section you can think about. So to summarize, I started from the observation that news personalization perhaps hasn't really lived up to the expectations that we have of it when we look at the tech giants. I then explained that we, and by we I mean the newspaper industry, can't expect to get the same results from personalization as the tech giants do when they are putting personalization front and center of their entire experience, and newspapers are still considering personalization and content recommendations as a nice-to-have feature, which is hidden at the bottom of their pages. I then offered you my view on at least a part of the solution, how to get more impact out of your personalization, which is to put intelligence and personalization behind more other sections of your website instead of just sticking to the popular articles widgets or recommended for you widgets. If you have any questions or remarks, please feel free to reach out at us at froomel.ai. Bye-bye.